In St. John, the sixth chapter, since we don't have much time, let me abbreviate the text and read just the 8th and 9th verses on this Mother's Day, too. And one of your disciples, Andrew, Simon Peter's brother, said unto him, there is a lad here which has 5 barley loaves and 2 fish, small fish. But what are they among so many? There is a lad here has 2 barley loaves and 5 fish. But what are they among so many? And I want to ask you, what are you feeding your children for lunch? What do you give them for lunch? This boy got this from his mama. He would have never had it if mother had not given it to him. And I think this is so important on this Mother's Day, is to ask you the question, what are you giving them? Most of you know the story that here was a situation where there was 5,000 men, beside the women, beside the children, that had been with Jesus not only all day long, but some said they had been with him 2 or 3 days. They were hungry, almost about to faint, weak, tired. And there were 2 or 3 solutions, or people who tried to come up with solutions. Some of the disciples said, send them away. That's an answer. We don't, as Christians and as a church, believe in sending people away. Don't let that be your answer to the needy. Philip said, let's see how much money we got. And said if we had 200 pennies, that was a lot of money then. So that still wouldn't be enough for all of these people. Andrew says, I found a boy with some lunch. But even, what is that? 2 fish, 5 loaves of bread. 3 different solutions, and neither one was a solution altogether within itself. Let him send them away. You know, let's see how much money we got. Let's add up our little trade to see what we got. Let's buy some. Andrew, Simon, Peter, brother, they found a lad, a boy here. 2 fish. 5 loaves of bread. Yeah. Jesus said, bring them to me. Now, the solution to this problem, the boy's lunch, was predicated upon what his mother put in the lunch.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And I'd have to ask you, what are you feeding your children? Is it a junk? Potato chips? Cracker Jack? peanut butter and jelly. I mean, some of us feed our children junk. It's not nutritious for them. And certainly won't help anybody else. And I want you to think about, what are you feeding your children? Will it be helpful, nutritious? Will it help anybody else? Well, what I'm really trying to bring you to today in this short message, what are you putting into their lives? And you have to start early. What are you putting into that boy and that girl's life that will help them to live? And help somebody else to survive. It's up to you. Don't expect the school to do it. Don't expect the church to do it. We do what we can. Don't expect community organizations. Don't expect politicians. That responsibility is yours. Now you can try to pass the buck all you want to. And in this situation, you know, mama is the one that fixed the lunch. Your task as mother, and it's an honor to be a mama. Honor, it's an honor. It's an honor. I know y'all don't like children no more. Y'all have done away with more children you'll ever have. Oh, what an indictment, huh? All right. Suppose your mama had been that cruel.
Come on now. Preach it.
Say it. And then, when you are fortunate enough, we don't take any real time to put something in their lunch, something in their lives that will help them to be a man or a woman, and not only help them, but help others. Now this mama had to really feel proud when this boy returned home and said, "Mama, the lunch you gave me fed 5,000 men. Beside the women and children." Any mother, any parents will feel proud of their children when they've been a blessing to somebody else. If you are a blessing at all, whoever you are, I thank God for my mama. Mama, thank you. Thank you, Esther Nolly. She's gone on to glory. But what you put in my life, somebody ought to say hallelujah. What you put in my heart, in my mind, in my spirit, mama, thank you. I know some of us didn't like it. Some of us didn't appreciate it at the time. But you can't feed them peanut butter and jelly. You can't feed them cracker jack and expect it to be nutritious. You just can't feed them off the television and junk like some of us. And they grow up to be decent. And make you feel proud of them. Well, I noticed two or three things here. Five barley loaves, two little fishes. One of the loaves that you ought to put in your child's lunch ought to be some rules.
All right. Right. Come on.
They must learn some rules at home. There are some laws. And nothing like home training. Just can't let children grow up might doing anything that they want to do. And every home must have its own rules. Did you have rules? You can come in when you want to. Go when you want to. Talk back. Did you hear what I say? There are some do's and don'ts. You must be governed by the rules of this house. I ain't talking about what the child is doing down the street. We have our own. Don't tell me about what they are doing. Now, I know we're a little more liberal now and you can do it. But when I came along, one of the laws was in our house that we couldn't even play cards. We couldn't dance. You can't teach them to gamble at home. Huh? And then tell them don't gamble at the casino. You can't sit down and drink beer and wine with them. Well, Mama, they do it at Miss Mary's house. This ain't no Miss Mary. And you know what? A child that has been taught rules and regulations, one thing, now you don't even have to know Mama when you see a child like that. And I hear you say they came from a well-trained house. They know how to be mannerable. Can I get a witness? Yeah. Rules. Shake somebody's hand. So there got to be some rules here. And children want rules. They may act like they don't want them, but they want to know somebody laying down the law. In the lunch, so loaf number one, ought to be some rules and regulation. And then it won't be that hard for them to understand that when they go to school and when they go up and start to drive in cars and one thing or another, to obey the law. In the lunch, thou to be a reverend for life, a reverend for other people. Well, let me put it this way, if you want respect. Now, you know some of these children you see today ain't got no respect. Talk back to me, somebody. They ain't got no respect for mama, for papa, for adults. These little children will curse you out. That's the reason why some of us are afraid to say something to them. And especially out in the street. But if they come in here, do you hear what I'm saying? Now, I hope you got your loaf of respect from home. Mama made us respect Lou Dell and Gladys, the other girls. You got to learn how to respect your sisters and brothers. You got to learn how to respect your mama and daddy. You may not like it. Am I right, Mama? If you didn't do it, you got a backhand lip. You don't talk to them any kind of way. And some of this stuff I see on television. It's a sin and a shame. There's no respect for anybody. Hear me what I'm saying. What do you put in your lunch? What are you feeding them? What are you putting in their lives? Are you checking up on it once in a while to see whether it's nutritious or not? Don't just give them in and everything. And don't expect somebody else, a babysitter and somebody, to teach them. to put the loaf in. You got to do it yourself. The Lord is holding you responsible. Look at that. Shake somebody's hand. I'll be through in a minute. And tell them, ask them, so what do you put in your children's lunch? What are you putting in their lives that when they get out of the house, it will do them good? Can't give them junk. While that girl is down there going to school and whatnot, it depends on how decent she is, whether she respects the teacher, whether she know how to come home at night and study her lesson and go to bed, or whether they go in there trying to tell the teacher what to do and come home all night, times of night, and party and get mad with everybody else because they don't know the lesson. Oh, man, you got the sign going up. I'm going to talk a little while.
Go on, man, preach. Go on and preach,
I think that you need to put in the lunch also what real value is. An appreciation for value. Because we're putting value on the wrong thing now. Being popular, being famous. All these different styles that are coming by. Baby, you don't need to wear some of this stuff. And you don't even have to keep up with the latest style. What is really valuable that will last? Yes? Teach them to. Education, baby, is very important. That's valuable. And the next thing is that if you want something, don't be afraid to work for it. One of the loaves. Work won't kill you. Work will help you to get what you want without stealing from somebody else. It's honorable. What are you giving your children? And you teach by precept and example. If you lazy, you won't work. Can I get a witness? They ain't gonna do it. This is the thing that will help them in life instead of sitting around waiting for somebody to give them something. And if you won't give it to them, they'll steal it or take it. As I come to a close, I want you to think about it seriously. Because, baby, if you give them the right kind of lunch, you can go on to heaven. It'll still work. There are some things that parents have taught us, and they've gone on, but it has stayed with us. Can I get a witness? Told us how to be obedient, told us how to respect rules and regulations, told us how to respect other folk. And you know, let me go back to that just a moment, because we were taught to respect old folk. They didn't have to be our parents. Just a matter if they were older. And I told y'all, you don't have to do it now because this is a different time and that kind of thing. Ain't no problem for me to say, yes, ma'am. No, ma'am, yes, sir. It's just mannerable. And in our culture, don't get carried away with what other folks doing. People used to think, you know, that I get upset and so forth because in our culture, the man of God was old Reb, the parson, the preacher, the elder. But in this day and time, they call them by their first name. Just hear me, catch enough of this on television, okay? I resent it. I don't want no mama come up calling me Clay. I'm your pastor. Now, other cultures, they do that and think nothing about it. But if you take that away from me, I can't be nothing else. It's just respect. It helps you. Don't care what you call me or don't call me. You can't change me. But it just shows respect. Reverend. And you young preachers are going to face that. Because that's what they do, John, Tom, Harry, and so forth. But well, anybody can be John, Tom, Harry. I'm pastor. Father, not just Jack Joe. In the religious community. She put something in this, and maybe she didn't even know what she was doing at the time. Two fish, five loaves of bread. You don't recognize sometimes what you are really doing. Far-fetched. But you ought to teach that child to be honorable, respect, and not lazy, and appreciate the real value of life. It's not fur coats, it's not cars, it's not a chain around that neck. Talk back to me something. It ain't the hair and the head on their head, it's what's in their head that really count. For if you can get something in your head, in your heart, man, you can make it. I tell y'all that all the time. The secret of my success, I've tried to be. You know, have a good heart, clean heart, a right mind. And mama taught it to me. Man, got that in the home, at home, a little two-room place. We had home, didn't have much of a house, because at night, y'all continue on with this, because I got another point I want to bring in, okay? You know, that when it would rain, we had to move to bed. I know you all don't know nothing about that. That's why, man, we didn't have no carpet on the floor. We had linoleum. And it had little designs in it. And when you kept on scrubbing that, they lost the design. We had newspaper up at the windows. Not because it was decoration, that was to keep the cold out. And look down through the floor and see the chickens and the dogs under the house. Man, when I think about where the Lord had brought me from. But taught us to love one another. It didn't just happen in Ludell and myself, and Joe and Ferris and Gladys are close to each other. That didn't just happen. It doesn't just happen if your parents don't put a loaf of love in there. You'll never get it. Teach them how to forgive one another and love each other in spite of.
Well, I'm in Lowe's with a fire. What I talked about, three.
Are y'all counting, huh?
No, that's another one. This isn't the character. We got to teach our young people, and then that loaf ought to have a loaf of have character. You can't buy a character.
reputation is what people say. Your character is what you are. And the morals of our young people now is bad. Somebody talk back to me, will you? Look over there. If y'all give me about 6 more minutes, I'll be through. Just say we ought to have a loaf of character. A loaf of character. Teach them how to really be somebody. Have some morals. All of this cussing. All of this drinking. All of this blowing the horn. Playing loud music all night. They won't sleep, won't let you sleep. Oh, I'm gonna say something after a while. You don't have to tell them, they don't have to do everything somebody else do. But have real character. And what people think of that now is nothing. But it pays to have character. And I want us to remember that as the adults. All of this drinking, all of this cursing, and all of this gambling, and all of this free sex. You ain't got no character, no morals for yourself. And how can you teach others? Can I get a witness? Character will stand. Some people will not appreciate it. But there's some things I just can't do. Mama taught me that. And I have to just stand for certain things. Hallelujah. Because I believe in a long run, we're going to win. Shake somebody's hand and say, in a long run, you're going to win. All of this dope, all of this stealing, all of this killing, can I get a witness? And some people, their conscience don't even bother them. Have you ever seen that? All of us, we sin short, come short of the glory of God, fall short. But baby, if you got some character, and we're going to get to the last point in just a minute, it bothers you. You just can't wallow in the hog pen and be satisfied because your nature don't call for that. A pig can do it. But if something happened in your life and you know that it's morally wrong, it's really against your character, it bothers you. Have I ever had anybody like that? You go home at night, you can't even sleep. There are some people, the more wrong they do, the more they... Well, what are you putting in the lunch? What are you feeding them? Mamas, because you're great teachers, nourishers. It's going to be profitable or either it's going to be damnable. It's going to do good or bad. And you may be dead and gone on. Where are you going? That's the reason why you need to be careful. Or what you put in their lunch, in their lives. Because what you sow is going to reap. And some of us look back over our lives now and then find our children doing this and that, and it grieves our heart. And if you really think about it, you didn't take the time when they were on your lap.
Subscribe to Brother Rollins' Videos for Christ on YouTube. We post brand new content every week with powerful preaching for ministers and pastors all across the nation that seek to encourage people all over the world through the word of Jesus Christ. You will also find gospel songs and old-time hymns that have inspired generations of Christians. Subscribe today and hit the bell so you never miss new content. YouTube.com/BrotherRollins. Spell it. B-R-O-T-H-A Rollins. Brother Rollins Videos for Christ on YouTube.